you will find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest me table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Somebody bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquity, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies you with good as long as you live, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord works vindication and justice for all those who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his acts to the people of Israel. I come to tell you that the Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. He will not always chide, nor will he keep his anger forever. He does not deal with us according to our sin, nor requite us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his steadfast love toward those who fear him. So far as the east is from the west, so far does he remove our transgressions from us. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear him. For he knows our frame. He remembers that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass. He flourishes like flower of the field. For the wind passes over it, and it is gone, and its place knows it no more. But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon those who fear him, and his righteousness to children's children, to those who keep his command. For the Lord will not cast off forever, for though he cause grief, he will have compassion, according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he does not willingly afflict, or grieve the son of man, to crush underfoot all the prisoners of the earth, turn aside the right of a man in the presence of the Most High, to subvert a man in his cause. The Lord does not approve. Who has commanded and it came to pass, unless the Lord has ordained it? It is not from the mouth of the Most High that God and evil come. What shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spares not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Who is he that condemns? It is even at the right hand of God who has made an intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ our Lord. Now this I say, my brothers and my sisters, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. But he says, behold, I show you a mystery, that we shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So that when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, that death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory. Y'all, we got victory, y'all. Amen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved Taylor family, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know, our labor is not in vain.
You made a way, you made a way. Forever and ever and ever. My name is Cameron. I am one of many nieces of my Uncle Troy. I refer to him as Uncle. You might refer to him as Deacon Troy or Doherty, or maybe, according to my grandma, some people used to call him T-Man when he was younger. That was before my time. Or maybe you call him Carolyn Troy, just lumping the two names together. Some people do that. But whatever you refer to him as, it's clear that you love him because you showed up today to celebrate his life. So I thank you for your presence today. I'm going to be reading Psalm 34. So if you will join me in opening your Bibles if you have it, or your Bible apps if you want to scroll with me, that works too. All right, just let me know once you have it. Psalm 34, we're going to start at verse 1. And it reads, I will bless the Lord at all times.
Yeah.
His praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. Those who look to him are radiant, and their faces shall never be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles.
Yeah.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who takes refuge in him. Oh, fear the Lord, you his saints, for those who fear him have no lack. The young lions suffer want and hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. Come, O children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is there who desires life and loves many days that he may see good? Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Turn away from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are toward the righteous, and his ears are toward their cry. The face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to cut off the memory of them from the earth. But when the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. He keeps all his bones, not one of them is broken. Affliction will slay the wicked, and those who hate the righteous will be condemned. But the Lord redeems the life of his servants, and none of those who take refuge in him will be condemned.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. Verse 14, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from the heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Glory. Then we shall, okay, hallelujah. And for some reason, God had given me that verse again. 17. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. May the Lord, he's already added a blessing to his word. But let us not only be hearers of the word, but doers of the word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This truly is the day that the Lord has made. It's bittersweet. This is a bittersweet day. Because my brother suffers no more. It's bittersweet. God does all things well. He does all things well. And I want you to know that when God come on the scene, he bring everything you need. He said nothing missing and nothing broken. He's a God of completeness. We've been laying dual for night. But our joy will come in the morning. I do want to say a thank you to the pastor of this great church, to the leaders of this great church. This pulpit is beautiful. Thank you all for coming. We feel your prayers. Keep praying for us. We may endure for a night, but our joy is coming in the morning. Let's give the Lord. Thank you.
what his role was. He might have endured so much, but you know that he who suffers will reign. If you want to suffer with him, if you want to go through much suffering here, you're going to reign with him. If you want to reign, you're going to suffer. So my heart is grateful today. I bring you greetings from Carrying the Cross Ministry. And to my extended family, the Mabry family, Taylor family, I love you all. I'm praying for you all. I remember Troy and Carol. We had so many great times, the fellowships at their home, and the fellowships, the prayers. Man, we had some encounters that y'all couldn't even imagine. But nevertheless, God is good. I ask that you all keep them in prayer. Because they need your prayers. Because everybody's assembled today, and everybody was assembled on last week, but late in the midnight hours, that's when they're going to need you. Amen? Come on, let's go to the throne of grace. Most gracious, just and everlasting Father, I call on your name, the only name that matters. I call on your name because, God, you're so grateful, and you're so just, and you're so kind. Oh, God, I thank you just for this morning, just for the way that you've allowed me to wake up, just for the adoration, Lord, of lifting my hands and giving you honor, who is the Alpha and the Omega. Lord, I thank you for being, oh, God, the one, oh, God, who caused the waters to cease in the time of trouble. God, I thank you, Lord, God, for leading and guiding me into all things. God, I pray for the family on today. I'm praying that you would touch them. Hearts. I'm praying that you would touch their walk. Oh God, I'm praying that you would touch their conduct. I'm praying, God, that they will stay in alignment and get in alignment with those who may not be in alignment with you. I'm praying all things to turn around. God, I pray that you will mend the broken pieces, put their hearts together like only you can. And God, I'm praying, oh God, for weeping may endure for a night, but we know that joy comes. Now, Father, we give you all honor and all praise in your magical name of Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
See me now. Church of Kennedy, Virginia. God was given in wisdom and his divine power gently ushered one of our most humble, soft-spoken angels home on Saturday, October 14, 2023. Deacon Troy D. Taylor completed his earthly journey to reside in his eternal home, a place of peace, love, joy, and no more pain. The Bible states that weeping may endure for a night, but joy surely comes in the morning. Deacon Taylor confessed his life to Christ at an early age and joined the Zion Baptist Church. After marrying his lovely, devoted wife, Carol, in 1987, he moved his membership to Rocky Mount Baptist Church. Deacon Taylor and his wife became members of the Ogden Ministry, and he also served in the men's ministry. Deacon Taylor had been battling his health since 2013, and yet continued to press his way to church, serving and doing for others. Deacon Taylor was very dedicated to his family, friends, and loved ones. We pray that during this challenging time, he will adjust to earthly life without his physical presence, but you will find strength in comforting arms of our Lord. Today, Pastor Jordan, First Lady, and the entire Rocky Mount Church family express our love and sympathy. Humbly submitted from the Rocky Mount Baptist Church, Reverend Carlos M. Jordan, Pastor, Faye Procise, Church Clerk. The 11 Oaks Baptist Church, to the family of Deacon Troy Taylor, this letter is written to each of you to let you know that the pastor and members of 11 Oaks share with you in this difficult time of sadness. Please know that we are praying for you. To the family, we pray that God will place you in his loving arms. May the peace of God dwell with you forever. Reverend Barry O. Brown, Senior Pastor, and the 11 Oaks Baptist Church. Carrying the Cross Ministries, Petersburg, Virginia. To the family, Apostle Lorenzo Baines and the Carrying the Cross Ministries family, express our heartfelt condolences for the loss of your loved one, whom God has called from labor to reward. Our hearts are saddened by the death of your loved one, but to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. We are comforted in knowing that Almighty King is a faithful warder concerning those that he has promised. God has promised he will never leave us comfortless. He will encourage us to call upon the Lord, and he is our refuge. With deepest sympathy, Apostle Lorenzo Baines, Carrying the Cross Ministries, Petersburg, Virginia. Rhema Word Ministries in Petersburg, Virginia. To Tierra, on behalf of Bishop Sean Lewis, First Lady, and Elder Shelley Lewis, the ministerial staff and members of Rhema Word, we offer our deepest condolences of the passing of your father, Troy D. Taylor. Tierra, our thoughts and prayers, our well wishes are with you. You are not alone during this time of bereavement. God's love reaches us to touch our smallest concerns and our greatest needs. Regardless of the circumstances, tears, and pain that we bear, our God is ever in control, performing as he promised in his word. As we learn to cast out all our cares upon him, and we learn to put our cares on him. Tierra, please know that death is not the end, but a transition to a place free of pain and suffering. As the word of God reminds us in 2 Timothy 4:7-8, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give unto me unto that day. And not unto me only, but unto all of them that love his appearing. Family, we are praying for the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. We send a watch over your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Lovingly submitted, Bishop Sean Lewis, Senior Pastor, Rhema Word Ministries in Petersburg, Virginia. Third Baptist Church, 500 Farmer Street, Petersburg. To Brother Mark Taylor and family, the Third Baptist Church was saddened to hear the passing of your brother, Deacon Troy D. Taylor. Please know that your church family shares in your grief. We know that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. We are praying that you will be comforted with precious memories in God's presence to carry you through. If there's anything that we can do, please feel free to call upon us. Please know that the church family is here for you, respectfully submitted with our sincere condolences. Reverend Cassandra Bullock, Pastor-elect, Deacon Shirley Dobie, Church Clerk. Again, to each of you, thank you for sharing this intimate moment with the family as we celebrate the life of Deacon Taylor. A reminder of a poem that we often use in times as this, and I'm sure it will be the sentiments of Deacon Taylor, a poem that simply says, "When I have come to the end of the road and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in the gloom-filled room while I cry for a soul set free. Miss me a little, but not too long, and not with your heads bowed low. Remember the love that we once shared. Miss me, but let me go. For this is the journey we all must take, and each must go alone. It's all a part of the master's plan, a step on the road to home. So to the family, when you are lonely and sick in heart, look to all these friends that you know, and bury your sorrows in doing good deeds. Miss me, let me go. Family, we continue to pray for you in days to come. God bless you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I too happen to be last. hardest working employees is a testament to his unwavering commitment and work ethic. When you think of a hard worker, you see Troy's smiling face. Troy worked work at Brinko was not limited to his regular hours. He went above and beyond, often working longer hours than most. Even while working a part-time job at Food Lion, his dedication was unparalleled. When I sought out stories about Troy, many of them were too colorful to share at his funeral, especially by the HR person. But they all echoed the same sentiments. He was pleasant, hardworking, laid back, non-confrontational, and he worked more hours than anyone else. He bought a liking for Squincher, the electrolyte drink that was provided to the Heatreat employees. He had an obsession for Serena Williams. His locker was adorned with her pictures. He loved playing a lottery and had a unique tradition of picking his numbers based on the number of parts he produced during the shift. He always exclaimed, "I'm going to play that number." So Troy's journey with Brinko began on June 1st, 1984, and despite a brief layoff in 85, he returned in 86 to continue his long and successful career. While a seniority of 30 years, he rose the ranks, starting as a machine operator in machining, Heatreat, and eventually taking a leadership role in Heatreat. In 2009, he transitioned to a security guard on the night shift, where I had the privilege of working with him closely. Troy's perfect attendance multiple years in a row underscored his reliability and his drive, making him an indispensable member of our team. In his performance reviews, he was described as a positive influence to the team, someone who was always on top of things and seldom made mistakes, a person who willingly stepped in for his co-workers facing hardships. In the Heatreat department, where he spent most of his career, Troy was part of a close-knit family. They looked out for each other and they shared a bond that extended beyond the workplace. One of the most memorable stories of Troy was his fascination of a particular Mountain Dew bottle with spent cigar tops left behind by his late co-worker, Don Brown. Don had decorated the bottle with strange drawings and numbers, which Troy believed had some mystical significance. Troy faithfully played the numbers that adorned it. It was a testimony to his respect for his colleague and the tradition he held dear in honor of his late friend, Don Brown. The legend reports that after many years, that bottle was eventually thrown away by Stanley Hill, adding to the strange mystical significance to that bottle. For those part of the Brinko family, you know the rest of the story. Before I continue, I would like to ask all current and former Brinko employees to please stand. Troy's loved ones. May that find solace in knowing that he was a cherished by many, but not just as a co-worker, but as a cherished member of the family. In Detroit, you left a profound mark on all of us, and your memory will live on in the stories we share, the laughter we remember, and the bonds you helped us help strengthen. Rest in peace, dear friend, colleague, and family.
Troy's life as it is fulfilled through the scriptures. So we're going to take some scriptures but incorporate Troy's life into it. Starts off with Genesis 5:24. Troy, like Noah, had a heart to please God. He understood that God saved him by grace. Troy walked in integrity. He was obedient and shared his faith with God with others. He made a mark and preserved everyone he met, and every challenge he overcame through faith. Job 1:1. Troy was God's servant. He walked upright like Job. He was well loved. His many good deeds. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plan I have for you, declares the Lord's plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plan to give you hope for the future. Troy exemplified that his future was in God's hands. Matthew 6:33. Deacon Taylor began every day seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, believing all good things would be added to him. Romans 12:2. God's Son didn't conform to his world, but he is constantly transformed by the renewing of his mind. Said Troy will often sit in his car alone at night listening to God's word, and Troy would tell Pearl, I'm going to church. And lastly, now, Paul says, now if we're his children, then we are heirs of God and co-heirs of God with Christ. Deacon Troy had a relationship with Christ. He lived a life to please his Lord, his Master, his owner, and his Savior. Troy loved the Lord. He loved Curl and his family. He loved wearing Stacy Adams shoes to school. He loved buying roses for the love of his life, the former Curl neighbor. He loved styling and profiling his sisters Bergen and Firebird. Troy loved life. Troy loved his mother, Bertina Taylor. They shared an unbreakable bond. Rest easy in peace, shalom, till we meet again. Lovingly written and submitted by the Taylor family. Thank you.
Thank you.
too bad.
describe my father. A loving, caring father, a grandfather, a God-fearing man. There was absolutely nothing my dad couldn't do. To some people, you may even thought he was a superhero, but in my heart and in my eyes, he was my superhero. Time wasn't on our side, but we never questioned God's work every minute, every hour, every day. Dad, you will be missed. All those long, I remember picking him up from the dialysis. He said, "Tia, go back there." And so that's the type of person he was. He was just always neat. And what I loved about him, he had always had a humble spirit. And I told him one night, we were stopping shelves. And I told him, I said, "Man, how do you do this? You got Branko, Food Lion." I mean, he had 2, 3, 4 jobs. I don't know how many jobs Troy had. But it was just a joy working with him. And one night I told him, I said, "I just want to be like you. I want to have a wonderful wife, children. I want to work hard and accomplish great things in life." And he said, "Jordan, you know what? You can get all of those things. Just be humble and just work for what you want." And I just thank God for that. And you never know, and that's why I tell people all the time, you got to be careful how you treat folk. Because you never know when you may cross paths with them. And so in becoming the pastor of the Rocky Mountain Baptist Church in 2010, the Bible, as our church was growing and growing in leaps and bounds, in 2010, the Lord placed in my heart that we needed to look around the congregation, as the book of Acts, chapter 6, verse 3, it says that we need to look amongst us, not judge folk, but make sure that they are full of the Holy Spirit, wisdom, and knowledge. I wish I had a witness on here. Amen. And so Troy and his wonderful wife, they exemplified these attributes, and they became part of our diaconate ministry in 2012, but they served diligently. And I just want to say, I thank Deaconess Carol and Deacon Troy for doing God's work and being part of us, the Rocky Mount Baptist Church, in the diaconate staff. Amen. And so today, to my right, the entire diaconate is here, so I would like them to stand. Also, all of our ministers. And matter of fact, Deacon Troy had an impact on the entire Rocky Mount Baptist Church. So with all of Rocky Mount in the house, would you please stand?
it is preaching time. Amen. So we're going to pray for the preacher today, my little brother, my Pastor Alexander Williams. Amen. We're going to pray for him. But we know that Troy's life has already, amen, been spoken of. He just lived a wonderful life. And so we want to pray for my brother. But at this time, we want to hear from Minister Ramona Reigns. Come on, show her some love.
That's why I'm saved.
will trust in the Lord until I die. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust.
Thank you. To God be the glory.
Amen.
To God be the glory. And Troy has made this easy for me today. Because some folk, we gotta make up stuff. You gotta rehearse stuff. You gotta make it sound pretty. Because they live like a hellion and didn't wanna die and go to heaven. Says, some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days.
Church and my pastor, check. Try to live a good life.
check. Treated people right, check. Faithful to my assignment, check. Made sure my wife and my children had what they need, check. Make sure I showed Tiara what a good man ought to be, check. Showed Brandon what a good man's supposed to do for his family, check. But there was one more box, my Bertina, that Troy couldn't check off. Because that box said, well done, thy good and faithful servant. And while Carol was holding his hand, and while Mama was rubbing his head, telling him it's okay to go, around about 12:44, God stopped by Southside Regional and checked off that box. And he heard the voice of the master say, did you try to tell her? You've been faithful over a few things. Come on up and I'll make you ruler over many. So well done. Well done. That good and faithful servant. That's all I got. Had a whole lot more, but you gotta understand, everything you got it may not be what God got. So whatever y'all do, don't miss heaven. Don't miss heaven. Learn something for Troy life. More tissues, y'all ready? All right, because I can still talk. Now, y'all saw in that video, the last two clips, Troy heard the music, them feet got the shuffle. On beat, off beat, them feet got the shuffle. And he had a good old time. So I need the organist, the drummer. Can I say it like I want to say, Brandon? Drop it.